Now, you had mentioned, and this is what I wanted to say before the podcast started, is that your brother, 88 Nate, 88 Nate Hardy, is also one of my longtime friends that I've known for years.
He was also on the show.
Yeah. He was on the very early stages of this show when we were still...
That was the funniest episode ever.
When we were at the trap house,
that's
bro.
That's when Keem spit out water.
And so you guys together, you're this label called
Digital Gold Entertainment. Right. Yeah. Because as you know, that song Digital Gold that he dropped, which was, I don't want to take credit, but it was my idea. Like I brought him the idea of the song. I said, hey,
I'm pretty sure you got him into Bitcoin, period.
Exactly. But I was like pretty big into Bitcoin, crypto. I'm just on Reddit all the time, on the forums. I'm like, man, there ain't no rappers talking about this, like, at all. Like, we need to talk about this.
Yeah.
So I brought it to Nate. I got him into crypto. I was like,
all the rappers who were doing it were super cheesy with it,
exactly.
too.
Exactly. They didn't understand anything below surface level of it.
Right.
They were just trying to catch
a
wave.
Exactly, yeah.
They're kind of doing like a hard knock life version of
exactly,
the rap game, right?
Yeah.
How you could talk about the gangster life, or you could do like a hard knock life, silly kind of song.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure. But Hard Knock Life was hard, though. But yeah.
I meant the chorus.
I brought him in. I was like, I educated him on crypto, blockchain, everything. Mm-hmm. Like, I made sure he knew it at a deep level to where he could actually explain it. I was like, make a song about it. And we was going back and forth for a while. He was like, bro, I'm not making a song about fucking crypto. This shit is dope. I'm investing in it. I like it. But ain't nobody trying to hear me rap about crypto, blah, blah, blah. So, bro, it took me...
That sounds like Nate,
exactly.
bro. That sounds like him.
You know how hard I got to coerce him into doing stuff.
So, real quick, me, Josh, and Nate are in this group chat that we've been in for like a year and a half. Like 2-3 years, bro. We've been in that group chat. Every time we present Nate an idea... Nah, it shouldn't be that way. That's stupid. That's a gimmick, you know. Even though we're kind of coming from like a marketing, like what? How can you get more fans? Yeah. Kind of thing. He's always against it initially.
It's always combative initially, but he always ends up doing it, and it always ends up working out for the most part.
Yeah.
So back to Digital Gold, I coerced him into doing the song, and he did it. You shot the video, just random. I didn't even tell him to shoot the video. That was his idea.
Yeah.
I didn't tell him to print the hoodies. That was his idea. So once he gets on board, he's
now, which
on board.
Hoodies are you? Which hoodies are you? I said hoodies.
Hoodies. Which hoodies?
What Mexican accent? Which hoodies are you? Are you referring
the
to
the Blockchain Matter hoodies?
Boom.
Yeah. So bam, he prints up the hoodie, shoot the video, puts it up, semi-viral. Mm. Everybody who's anybody in crypto, retweeting it, sharing it. It blew up across the internet. To this day, I think it's close to 1 million across all platforms: Facebook, Twitter, Instagram.
Yeah.
What's it called? YouTube.
Yeah.
Close to 1 million across the whole internet.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. In the first like week or so, it got its 50,000 views on YouTube.
Yeah.
Alone. And that was just straight
and
up
Twitter.
Was that with like ad revenue or what's
Bro,
it called?
We have spent no ad revenue on
that's
it.
Crazy.
That was all
organic.
And you kind of couldn't, because that was also in 20. Like, was it late 2017?
It was late 2017.
And that was when Facebook and stuff had put like a ban
on crypto,
advertising.
Yeah.
I just remember
exactly.
why you couldn't do
that's
it.
Because
yeah.
I tried to. I remember I tried to put some money behind it because it was growing. I wanted to help boost our Granite growth.
Yeah.
But like you said, Facebook was blocking any cryptocurrency.
If that
promotion.
Song would have come out 2 months earlier, bro, but like in October, November,
I could have boosted the hell out of that.
You could have boosted it.
Yeah.
Capitalized on
yeah,
it.
Yeah, bro. But we still did good with that.
Yeah, I know.
Because with that record, I mean, it put us, we start getting flown out to do shows. We start printing out merch. Everybody wanted the hoodies. I was shipping shit to China, bro. Like, we was making money off them hoodies. So that put us in a decent spot to continue to scale and build a fan base. But the only problem is Nate didn't want to keep making crypto music. But that was who was his demand was. His audience was
right.
So it's like, bro, I'm trying to tell him you can't go against your audience. You got to fuck with who fucking with you.
Right.
So I'm trying to...
I still see it. Yeah. I still see it whenever he drops like a new video, people comment, when are you doing another crypto
exactly,
track?
Exactly,
you know,
bro.
Because the thing is, that community is so diehard because there's nobody representing
exactly.
it.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Exactly,
that's
bro.
Why Mexicans are so hardcore on whoever's like a big Latin artist, because they miss Selena, you know, like they need that artist to represent the culture.
Exactly.
You know?
So yeah, so part of my job is to trying to keep him to feed that audience. Like, yeah, I know you want to do like regular music, whatever you want to call that, regular music, but you also got to do a little crypto here and there too, just to keep feeding that base.
Yeah.
Because we can grow them. We can scale that. But we can also scale the regular music too. But it's going to be a lot harder with them because they're not really fucking with you all the way yet. Mm-hmm. But that's starting to change too, because the video y'all shot with the what was it? The one with the singing one where he was like in the shower and shit.
Oh yeah,
Surrender.
It was a surrender.
Yeah, so that shit is blowing up. That shit did like 50,000 views in Facebook in like the first 2 days. So like we got fans in different pockets. Mm-hmm. Like right now, our strategy is to just figure out exactly who they are and just keep Nate in their face, keep running the ads. Hey,
yeah.
That's basically the challenge right now. But it's a fun challenge and I love it, and it's working and it's growing and it's scaling, and the Spotify numbers are continually to grow every month. So that's just what it's about.
As long as you're seeing growth, man, that's what it's all about. Like, yeah.